Oke semua, langsung ini ya, back to back episode 14 dan 15 ya. Ini gue lagi buat episode 15 nya ya, karena kayak gue rasa 14 itu terlalu antiklimatik gue rasa. Jadi besoknya gue langsung rilis yang episode 15 gitu kan. Yay. Yeah. Ini kali ini kita gue mau selesaikan. Soalnya gue ada perasaan tertinggal gitu. Apa ini si Kuroiwa di episode 14, Kuroiwa tiba-tiba datang ya kan. Datang gini, saya mau nangkap, bukan nangkap, saya mau bawa si Yagami Sensei ke polisi. Oke, kita ini kebetulan dia masih di awal chapter di game gua ya, jadi kita langsung aja ya. Ini ada kayak cuplikan-cuplikannya. Oke, jangan lupa subscribe ya guys. Oke, lanjut.
The mole's latest victim was the lawyer, Shintani.
Shintani,
the last
guys.
Call he made brings the case that ruined Yagami 3 years ago back to the surface. A patient was taken from a hospital and found buried in the mountains. Yagami defended the suspect, Shinpei Okubo, and got an acquittal. But 1 month later, he murdered his girlfriend, Emi Terasawa, with a kitchen knife and burned the remains.
Shinpei Okubo ini kayak laki-laki sial gitu ya. Ini gue chapter berapa? Chapter 6, oke, chapter 6. Nanti gue bakal edit ya, by the way. Kayak adegan yang lari-lari gue edit, stalker gue edit. Soalnya
I'd like to speak to you as a material witness to the murder of the lawyer Masamichi Shintani.
Is that so?
I'm Hoshino, an attorney at Genda Law Office. Officer, is this interview voluntary or?
It is.
It's your call, Yagami-san.
I think I'll pass.
Excuse me?
You have your answer, sir. You can go now.
Oh, privacy tahu hukum,
guys.
You
can make this
guys.
Easier if you come now. Next time, it won't be voluntary.
Okay.
Your empty threats don't mean much to a lawyer.
Can you take this elsewhere? I really must be...
Too bad he's not a lawyer anymore, then. Your friend's nothing now. Just come along quietly. I'll come back with a warrant if I have to.
I'd like to see you try. Why do you suspect me anyway? I bet you don't even have a reason.
I can come up with a few good ones.
Enough! Get the hell out of my office.
Grafik boleh biasa-biasa aja, guys. Story.
Kuroiwa-san.
Jepang itu the best kalau Jepang. Story ya. Gua suka, guys.
You two, out.
Before we go, can we speak to Shono-san for a sec? We need to know why Shintani called him.
Listen, I already told you he doesn't know. Get it through your skull. Now, please leave.
No problem. We'll let you get back to work.
Kalau game... Kalau story Jepang itu oke lah, beberapa game itu oke.
This is really getting out of hand.
Sega lagi, Sega story itu oke.
I can't believe that detective thinks you're a material witness.
Yeah, I don't know what he's talking about. But what I'm more interested in is how he even knew where to find me.
That's a good point. How would the police know we were here?
Beats me. For now, let's focus on Shono though. It would be a waste coming here and not talking to him.
Agreed. Let's see if the receptionist can help us.
Oh ya, kenapa kok polisi bisa tahu ya? Kan dia nggak ada telepon polisi kan, guys? Aduh, tunggu. Kayak gini, adegan-adegan kayak gini, gue pasti cut sebagian.
Can I help you?
Actually, I've already been here. I was just with Director Kido, remember?
Oh, of course. Did you forget something, sir?
Well, not exactly. I'd actually like to speak to Shono-san, the 89 researcher. Where would I be able to find him?
Let me see. That should be the research wing. I believe he's in the protein abnormalities lab.
Probably need a gold keycard to get in there, huh?
That's correct, sir. I should be able to lend you one with the director's approval, though. Just give me a moment to ask. Could you tell me your name, sir?
Actually, never mind. Kido-san seemed pretty busy earlier. I'll try back later.
Are you sure, sir?
Good call. There's no chance Kido-san would let us in.
At least now we know where Shono is.
There is a swing, oh.
Yeah. I wonder if there's a map around here somewhere.
Ini yang gua sukanya ya. Gak usah terlalu diribetin kayak kita mesti cari-cari lagi.
Dan
langsung aja udah, to the point.
Hey, fine. The service entrance parking lot. All the delivery people come in and out.
Gua tipe gamer yang suka enjoy jalan ceritanya gitu. Okay, give it your best shot of your story, man, gitu. Daripada kayak main Dragon 2 mesti cari.
Hey, this is where we are now. The ADDC lobby.
Okay.
What the? Some kind of security gate, huh? The research wing must be just past there. Suspicious. This goes over to the hospital. I think Waku-san was up on the fourth floor. What the? This leads to the research wing.
The receptionist said he would be in the protein abnormalities lab, right? Huh. Well, I guess that's not on this map.
Excuse me.
Yes, ma'am?
This is one of Shono-san's researchers. She was just about to return to the lab.
Oh?
My name's Hashimoto. I can show you into Dr. Shono's lab if you'd like.
Are you sure?
Of course.
Great. We'll take you up on that.
Wonderful. Hashimoto-san just happened to be passing through.
Thank you.
Right this way.
Aku suka zaman-zaman era-era 2000 ke bawah gitu, guys. Di mana orang main game itu grafik
from the Gendala office. Thank you for doing this.
Oh, don't mention it. I'm glad to help a guest of
grafik enggak gitu penting.
This place is so massive. You practically need a tour guide.
Penting story, gameplay, grafik jangan busuk-busuk amat lah, udah itu aja. Paling penting itu dulu enak. Gak matching kone orang
mah. What kind of work do you yourself
sekarang,
do?
Grafik,
I'm part of the team developing 89. Dr. Shono is the head of that team, but
that's why I'm become a console gamer, guys. Karena simple.
Speaking of, what exactly does AD9 stand for?
Well, the AD comes from the name of the center. The Advanced Drug Development Center, ADDC. And it's the ninth drug our department's developed.
Oh, that was surprisingly easy.
Yo, mak. Ngeri juga ya rumah sakitnya ya. Ada sampai pintu besi kayak gitu.
It'll be the first dementia-curing drug on the market, right? Seems like it's really getting fast-tracked because of that. But there's a lot riding on this one, right? It could finally cure Alzheimer's disease.
That's right. Do you know how many dementia patients there are in Japan alone?
A couple hundred thousand, at least. Maybe even in the millions?
Right. As of 2012, there were 4.62 million.
4 juta.
By 2025, that number will increase to at least 7 million, potentially up to 13 million, including at-risk patients. That's one in every 9 people.
Yikes.
However, as a nation, we're already at capacity in caring for these patients. In many cases, people over 60 are stuck looking after their dementia-struck parents in their own homes. Worldwide, it's estimated there will be 135 million patients by the year 2050. It's staggering. In other words, AD9 could save the world. This could be a real miracle.
I gotta say, this is making me feel kind of bad about how we treated Kido-san back there.
Director Kido will go down in history if we achieve this.
A lot's changed in 3 years. Bastard's really made a name for himself.
Be nice.
Masih kesel ya si Yagami nih, guys. Oh ya, ada yang kasih gua suruh kasih dubbing Jepang, guys. Maybe later ya. Karena gua udah sempat record beberapa gitu. Nanti gua bakal ganti deh. Menurut kalian gimana?
Dr. Shono is right over there.
Coba ya.
Well, if you'll excuse me.
Shonara-san.
Yagami-san? But how did you get in here?
Hey, calm down. I just want to talk.
I can't do that. Kido-san doesn't know you're here, does he?
Is there a problem?
Oh, Ichinose-san.
I've never heard you raise your voice, Shono-san.
Aren't you the guy from the lobby?
My name is Ichinose. I'm here from the Ministry of Health, offering political support to AD9's development.
Wakil Menteri Kesehatan, Kaoru Ichinose. Okay.
Kido-san called you Vice Minister.
I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
Pretty lofty for a Vice Minister. You can boss scientists around, but I'm not biting.
So I see.
Shono-san, please. I just need a few minutes to talk. We'll leave right after we're done, promise.
I already told you, I can't. Not without Kido-san here.
I need you to tell me, why did Shintani call you?
Shintani? I've never heard that name in my life.
This is important, Shono. You have to have some idea.
Please, I don't. Now get out of here. I'm calling Director Kido.
Do what you want. Just let me ask you one thing first. After Shintani was murdered, the killer gouged out both of his eyes. Three other near-identical murders have taken place in Kamurocho recently. Are you aware of that, Shono-san?
Of course I am. It's all over the news.
And you still have no idea why Shintani called you? Nothing at all?
No, I don't. Now please let me get back to work.
What the? What are you doing here?
Kido-san.
I believe I told you to leave. What about that, didn't you understand?
I wanted to ask about Shintani's call.
About which I already said Shono doesn't know anything.
And I needed to hear that from him, not you.
Enough. Call security.
We were just leaving. Come on, Hoshino.
Ooh.
I'll be filing a complaint with the Bar Association. Under the minister's name.
The minister? Of health?
That's right. Minister Kazami expects great things from AD9, and he won't tolerate distractions from your ilk.
I feel like we came up empty-handed. Why would Shintani-sensei have called Shono-san? Yagami-san?
That wasn't the first time I've heard about Minister Kazami.
Huh?
When was it, though? Who was talking to me about the Ministry of Health?
Jawabannya sama Ayabe ya, teman-teman. Kan Ayabe yang kasih tahu.
It must have been Ayabe, when we were drinking over at Tender. I definitely remember him mentioning Minister Kazami. We were talking about how the Kyore clan ended up in Kamurocho. Apparently, they're being used as muscle for a construction company called the Kajihira Group. A while back, Chairman Kajihira himself was going around, laying the political groundwork for a Tokyo revamp project. And one of the people he met with was Naohisa Kazami from the Ministry of Health.
Huh.
You'd think he'd go to the Ministry of Land, though. His project has nothing to do with health. What would he gain from meeting Kazami?
That's true. Do you think it has to do with our case somehow?
I don't know. Depends on what the two of them are talking about.
In that case, maybe our Kajihira expert can help us out with that.
Who?
Sugiura-san. Sugiura. He used to work for them, remember?
Oh, yeah.
So, you want to know how Kajihira and Kazami are connected?
Yeah. Any way you can find that out?
Not really sure, but I'll give it a shot.
Thanks.
You're still at the ADDC, yeah? Just give me some time. I'll call you if I find anything.
Ini kasusnya udah berbelit-belit, guys. Kajihira, kita belum nyampe ya. By the way, tadi teman gue ada pesan katanya coba dites pakai bahasa Jepang. Cuma nanti gue coba ya, guys. Ini kayak memori HP gue pun, karena gue facecam ini pakai HP kan. Jadi agak goyah. Memorinya tadi gue lihat, turun dia langsung dari tinggal 30 giga.
Oh, Yagami-san. I'm gonna head back to the office. I just got an email from Saori-san. Apparently, a journalist named Hattori barged into the office. Says he wants to interview you.
Me?
It sounds like he's looking into Shintani-sensei's murder, too. Anyway, I'll go ahead and drive him off.
You'll be Genda-sensei's ace attorney before you know it.
Nah, I don't know if I'm ready for that. Honestly.
Why?
Too much responsibility for a guy my age, you know? I think I make a much better sidekick for now.
Okay, but when that gets old?
I don't know that it will. Being a professional sidekick for the rest of my life sounds okay to me. I'll see you later.
Oke, yang jelas banyak adegan yang bakal gua cut ya. Ini Sanamihama. Oh, ini nah, jadi gua main side case ketemu cewek. Jadi di sini kan bisa pacaran.
Sumimasen.
Hmm?
Ah, ini dia. Kan gua di episode sebelumnya ada bilang kayak fundraising gitu kan, guys. Ini kayak fundraising itu sekarang udah mulai trending gitu. Jadi di mana kita enggak perlu lagi cari orang-orang dengan uang yang besar. Jadi kita bisa kayak masuk ke suatu aplikasi atau website di mana itu bisa kita bisa galang dana, yang mana yang ngumpulin yang bayar dananya itu orang-orang kayak kita, kayak gua, kayak lu yang uangnya terbatas gitu. Nah, jadi dia nih kita bisa invest. Nah, siapa yang invest di situ minimal dengan sekian rupiah gitulah misalnya kan. Nah, pasti dapat bonus. Misalnya ada game baru, cuman dia contoh yang paling terasa itu ini Shenmue 3. Cuman Shenmue 3 mengecewakan ya. Apalagi yang Wonderful 101 itu yang sukses. Itu di crowdfunding sama masyarakat biasa, guys. Dan itu sukses gamenya, remake-nya. Kalau kalian mau main itu bisa di Switch ya. Dan gue kayaknya nggak bakal main sih, karena terlalu banyak game yang gue pengen main, kayak Ghost of Tsushima tentunya gitu kan. Nah, jadi intinya gini, kalau misalnya kalian pengen buka usaha atau apa, nggak ada dana, pakai crowdfunding nih boleh. Cuman jangan dipakai buat yang jahat ya, dasar. Jadi kalau misalnya siapa yang masuk itu kalian bisa kasih orang-orang yang invest kalian itu bonus. Misalnya kalau kalian buat game baru yang pre-order dapat bonus item apa gitu, yang ikut investasi gitu loh. Kickstarter namanya, lupa gua. Kickstarter. Ya sama kayak crowdfunding juga lah. Boleh tuh kalian coba kalau kalian ada proyek-proyek gitu kan. Coba aja Kickstarter. Mana tahu terkumpul. Kan. Ini Kickstarter. Nah, di sini kalian banyak ini, ada Cyber Secrets. Kayak gini, guys. Ini gua salah investasi, guys. Aturannya gua salah baca nih, huge pack bomb. Kayak mesti wajib kalau misalnya kalian mau bisa unlock semua skillnya ya. Karena kalau grinding pakai hajar Yakuza itu lama banget. Jadi grindingnya ini pakai namanya Huge Bomb Alpha. Huge Bomb Alpha ini yang versi apanya, nanti kalian penuhin baru dapat yang terbarunya Huge Bomb dia. Itu yang paling banyak dapat SP. Nah, ini aturannya challenge rule middle course ini. Gua salah 1 juta cumannya dia butuhin. Ya cari duit lagi pakai blackjack. Gitu. Yang jelas gua bakal banyak matang. Karena kayak gua main ini kayak bukan sengaja. Kayaknya kan sekali mil jalan sambil cari-cari ini item motor. Ini kenapa nih? Ini ibu kos kita nih, guys.
どうしようかしら? ねえ。 お願いね。
Nice.
Kalian mesti sering-sering ngerjain event friend sama side quest. Tujuannya apa? Satu, kayak bentuk quest starter dapat uang. Sama kalau kalian langsung ngebut ke jalan cerita, gak dapat feel-nya aja gitu, guys. Ya gue nggak juga mungkin nggak unlock, aku juga nggak bakal unlock 100%, nggak bakal, nggak keburu. Gue masih sering-sering cek timernya hidup nggak atau enggak ya kan. Sekarang muka udah jago loh. Sejak yang kalian nonton Death Stranding itu, guys. Sekarang mau rekam itu kan kayak kameranya dari segala sudut ya. Supaya dapat ini kita punya ekspresi wajah. Gila mah teknologi zaman sekarang. Ya, permintaan gamer kan, permintaan minta grafik bagus. Jadi cuman terakhir grafik bagus, memori pun tinggi-tinggi semua ya kan kayak.
Yep.
Call of Duty Warzone 100GB, gila men. Mungkin ini episode terakhir gua yang dimana gua pakai facecam kayak gini ya, guys. Nanti kedepannya gua pakai voice, kecuali di segmen Giba Gaming. Nanti terpilih lah. Soalnya gua pengen suatu nanti kalau gua udah pakai capture card, udah pakai ada Elgato gua, lagi nabung kan. Gua mau pakai laptop sama Elgato. Mungkin gue kalau belum afiliasi di YouTube, gue pakai Twitch dulu. Karena gue pengen live streaming gitu. Ngerasain aja gitu loh, kayak mana rasanya live streaming. Karena gue lebih suka kalau ngobrol itu dua arah gini loh. Gitu. Kita bahas tentang game. Cuman kalau kalian mau bahas cerita kalian ya, nanti kita buat episode khusus. Eto. Lalalalalala. Gue kelewatan nih. Nah, gue kalau jalan itu suka ini, guys. Ngutip-ngutip sampah. Material untuk drone atau apa gitu. Gue suka ngutip.
What's up?
Chuck.
Ada Ci. Nah, ini ada di gedegan ini gue bakal cut ya. Kayak stalking. Kita tuh lama banget soalnya. Gue mau cepet juga.
Chuck.
Batu gerak bir. Ini kawannya si Kaito-san nih, guys. Kawan lama Kaito-san. Ini si Marisan terus di sini ya. Oh iya, dia kerjanya penjudi, guys. Main judi itu kalau beruntung baru main judi dia. Ketawanya gitu.
Kaito.
New partner. Aku lucu aja sama animasinya. Oh, ditawari kerjaan, guys. Ini kawannya apa kan? Bekerja di bidang properti ya.
Kaito.
80.000 berarti 8 juta satu hari.
Aibo.
Aibo. 8 juta satu hari. Kerjanya jadi kayak bodyguard. Ya bodyguardnya bukan bodyguard sembarangan, guys. Lawannya Yakuza soalnya. Oke, kita cek dulu ya. Mana dia di side case. Ini Amane juga bisa jadi pacar kalian nih, guys. Jadi makanya side case itu berguna itu loh, jangan dibiarin. Gua udah lakuin banyak, cuman kalau yang enggak di main story gua enggak masukin. Tujuannya apa? Durasi YouTube ya. Gue main ini udah kayak temen gue udah banyak, tapi nanti sesuai dengan jalan cerita bakal tambah banyak gitu.
Hah?
Kaito-san dilawan, salah orang. Tapi gue dari spin-off Yakuza ini Judgment. Gua enggak melebih-lebihin karena gua betul-betul enjoy gitu. Karena gua main yang Yakuza 1 2 3 yang Kiryu-san ya. Cuman kan dulu gua belum YouTuber, jadi gua enggak bisa nge-record. Habis itu belum ada yang YouTube kan, misalnya belum terkenal sekarang gitu loh. Tapi Judgment, moga-moga ada Judgment 2-nya. Kalau ada Judgment 2-nya mungkin gua mau coba gitu. Karena so far sampai chapter yang ke-6 ini ya, berarti episode sekarang ini 15 ya. Ya, 15 kalau enggak salah. Gua betul-betul enjoy sama jalan ceritanya Judgment, guys.
Hey.
Cuman mungkin friend-nya lebih dibanyakin lagi. Sama grinding XP-nya tolong buat developer Sega. Grindingnya nih jangan-jangan sikit banget gitu loh, dari story, side quest, dari apa? Lawan-lawan mini boss gitu. Tolong XP-nya dibanyakin gitu loh. Sikit banget, guys. Makanya gue bilang tadi ada quick starter tadi kan, itu yang huge bomb itu kan masih, kalau mau saya mau full skillnya itu kan masih di masuk, pokok uangnya tuh butuh 2 juta yen dalam game ya, untuk investasi ke minuman itu. Ah, itu untuk ternak jurus gitu loh. Ternak jurus gitu. Karena gua grinding Yakuza itu cuma dapat Pak kelawan ketemu itu apa kehin geng itu paling cuma 80 lawan bosnya itu udah berkali-kali gitu. Emonya banyak kayak 500 gitu atau 1000 kan enak gitu loh. Terus side case-nya tolong diperbanyak ya. Ini belajar dari Spider-Man untuk PS4. Spider-Man PS4 kalau tanpa side quest itu cuma 2 jam 3 jam tamat. Itu new game plus ya kondisi ya. Kalau new game kan pasti kalian menjalanin ya kan. Tambahin cerita, tambahin apa. DLC itu penting makanya. Dan katanya lagi di dalam development kan. Spider-Man kedua untuk PS5 lah mungkin nanti keluar, atau PS5 dan PS4 enggak tahu. Gua jelas gua kumpul uang banyak yang mesti gua kumpulin duit untuk banyak gua mesti beli lah gitu. Nah itu Spider-Man udah keluar kan. Siapa ini? Ini Kehin geng. Bentar, cuma 9. Ya, mau naikkan dikit lah, 50 kek gitu kan. Sedangkan yang mau di-upgrade itu jumlahnya lumayan yang mau setiap skill yang mau gua upgrade. Itu minimal kayak 6.000, 5.000 sekali upgrade. Skill-skill yang penting gitu loh. Mau grinding berapa lama gitu. Tapi kalian seiring dengan berjalannya chapter, banyak banget kayak gini. Jalan dikit ketemu musuh, itu aja sih. Nah, mungkin rada annoying gitu. Soalnya kurang terasa rewardnya kayak gini. Kayak ini kayak drop item dikit. Terus udah drop item dikit. SP-nya dikit, maunya lebih banyak gitu loh, lebih rewarding lah, jangan terlalu pelit amat gitu loh. Jadi kalian kalau misalnya nggak tahu tips and trick itu cara cari duit di game ini ya rada susah gitu loh. Ini kan, jadi gua kok ke kiri itu tadi ketemu itu Yakuza, Kehin geng, nampak dari bajunya. Mana sih? Pokoknya nih, gua bakal cut dikit ya. Ghost of Tsushima guys. Aduh, gua tamatin walkthrough ini, tamatin Call of Duty. Kalau ada duit gua mainkan Ghost of Tsushima dulu daripada Final Fantasy 7 Remake guys. Karena Final Fantasy 7 kira-kira gua udah tahu enggak ceritanya gimana. Tapi Ghost of Tsushima itu satu yang fresh, suatu yang baru yang gua pengen coba gitu. Nah, nanti kita lihat aja lah ya. Gimana?
Irasshaimase.
Gimana? Ghost of Tsushima bakal memuaskan kita kah? Karena itu yang jelas dari Sucker Punch yang buat famous ya. Kalau kalian belum lihat, gua ada bahas episode khusus untuk bahas Ghost of Tsushima guys. Khusus untuk itu. Cuma nanti kita lihat lagi mana. Kalau Final Fantasy 7 remake bagus, bukan bilang nggak bagus. Gua udah tahu itu udah pernah ada tuh remake. Dan ini kalau gua pilih remake sama sesuatu yang baru, gua pilih baru gitu loh. Apalagi game baru mau keluar nih. Call of Duty Warzone udah rilis ya. Kalau kalian suka, gua udah main. Oke lah, not bad. Tapi itu 15 juta guys. Berarti yang streaming yang jago-jago pada keluar semua itu. Gila itu gua. Kalau kalian jalan di lapangan terbuka, cetang, kena headshot sniper. Hah. Oma, kalau Jo Masuda sampai mukanya gitu berarti ini orangnya brengsek ini biasanya.
Hah? Mhm.
Nah, ini salah satu yang gua agak kecewa dengan Jasmine itu. Kenapa karakter-karakter penting di game ini kayak Jomasuda, siapa-siapa gitu. Girlfriend-nya pun calon-calon girlfriend-nya kenapa enggak dikasih suara sih gitu? Kenapa harus tek-tek-tek-tek-tek-tek-tek-tek-tek-tek gitu? Gua agak kecewanya gitu, guys. Ya kayak Kak itu, kasih kayak suaranya apa sih? Mungkin ya gua paham juga faktor ini, guys, modal. Mau buat game dengan modal sekecil-kecilnya dengan untung sebesar-besarnya. Cuman kecil-kecil jangan game murahan gitu. Kalau kalian by the way tipe game yang beli game pas brand release atau udah sale. Kalau gua kayaknya kalau gua lah game-nya biar gua enggak gitu hype, tapi gua pengen main, gua nunggu sale kalau gua ya.
Tuck.
Nope.
Yo.
Adegan ini gue pengen kayak dengan suara Kaito kan. Tapi ya gue paham ini dikategorikan side case, guys. Ya JRPG lah. Ini termasuk action RPG, guys. Ada grinding, ada NPC, ada jalan cerita. Ya action RPG lah banget. Lewat. Nah, ini kalau kalian jalanin side friend quest, friend questnya, nanti ada kayak gue dapat ninja itu gue. Gue dapat ninja jadi bodyguard.
What a waste.
Tanoshi gona Goroharu.
Tanoshikatta de gozaru yo.
Tanoshi kota. Oh, Tanoshi susah banget bahasa Jepang. Kalau kalian bisa bahasa Jepang hebat. Apalagi yang ngomongnya cap cicus kayak air ya. Oke, lanjut quest. Geng, capek mah. Kayak geng itu gak akan selesai-selesai. Malah jadi bertambah, jadi 2 jadi 4. Ganti baju dulu. Ini baju, baju lagi di sini gak bisa beli, guys. Jadi mesti dapat dari quest-quest gitu bajunya. Ini kita dengar dulu kawannya si Adachi nih, sejarah apa dia. Jalannya gitu. Oh, nggak ketahuan ya.
Woi.
Cepat kali guys, kalian hati-hati ya. Jadi dia mau dapatkan tanahnya itu apa, anak tuan tanahnya itu di mau diperkosa terus direkam, mau diviralkan, mau apa, blackmail.
Hey. Chuck.
Kaito.
Kaito. Ini orang brengsek ini. Kadang teman kita enggak sekalam hati-hati ya. Rambut sama hitam tapi kita enggak pernah tahu.
Yo.
Oh, udah dilakukan. Gila, men.
Aibo.
Aibo my ass.
Yeah.
Huh?
Chuck.
Hmm?
Kaito.
Yeah.
Gak terima sih Yagami ya guys. Iyalah. Kalau Yagami tahu dia salah, dia tipenya. Nah kayak adegan gini kan sayang banget nggak ada suaranya gitu loh maksud gua. Ini kalau ada suaranya bagus gitu. Kaito kita guys. Lawan Kaito kita guys.
Yeah.
Talk.
Masahin Kaito. Kaito jangan tanggung-tanggung.
Ha!
Biar sadar dulu Kaitonya ini ya kan. Kaito-san kan. Apa alasan Kaito-san? Kita dengar dulu alasan Kaito-san kenapa.
Hah?
Kaito!
Duck.
Ha ha ha.
Yagami-san, it's Sugiura. Want to meet up and talk Kachihira? Heard of a place called Koi Bride?
Unfortunately, yeah. How do y'all know this place?
Just gotta have connections. Anyway, I'll see you there.
Oke, semuanya sampai di sini dulu episode 15. Jangan lupa subscribe, like, dan komen. Ini terakhir gue pakai facecam. Mungkin kedepannya nanti lihat gimana ya. Oke, dadah semua.